On today's show, culinary queries.
Gambarini, I have no idea what that is.
Does he not have a clue whatsoever?
I ain't got a clue what that is.
Agonising accents.
It's never really been said that I've got a posh accent.
I don't think that anybody around the table is stuck up their own backside. Everybody else sat on the table, they're talking who, la-da-da.
And dirty dancing.
Not sure that I would pay to go and see that.
There's four rival hosts battle it out for a £1,000 prize. Cities of Bristol and Bath, where for 1 week only our contestants can win 1,000 Bristol pounds to spend there. And what can that buy you? Well, one of these a day for 3 months. Oh, yummy. And hoping to be first past the winning post is our first contestant, operations manager and horse lover, Jen Watkins.
I do think I actually get on with horses better than people, probably because they don't answer back, we get along just fine, and they're my best friends.
And this horse whisperer has definite ideas on grooming.
I do try very hard to make myself look nice. It doesn't always happen. I am renowned for not brushing my hair that often.
Well, maybe Jen can make a good show of her dessert. Irish coffee with homemade shortbread. Chomping at the bit to get started, she melts dark chocolate, adds cream and coffee liqueur, then mixes.
Well, that's a bit of a cop-out. There's no cooking in that one. Make a shortbread, that's easy. My daughter can make that.
All right. Our second contestant is 44-year-old, uber-confident personal stylist, Michelle Sanfilippo.
I have some friends that admire me. I have some friends that are probably a little bit envious of me. I think you should always take pride in your appearance, your home, your cooking, your job, everything that you do.
I like the fact that people take pride in their appearance and what they wear. I would like to do that, to be honest, more often if I had time.
You and me both, Jen. What she does have time for is the mixing together of white chocolate, cream and Irish cream liqueur.
Yeah, that's perfect, look. Now, fingers crossed, it sets.
Dessert, Irish coffee with homemade shortbread. Now you're talking.
Someone who's no stranger to a bit of chat is 44-year-old comedy dancer, Steve Legg.
I absolutely love it when people laugh at my dancing because that's what I am. I'm a comedy dancer. It's absolutely brilliant, you know, when I get on that stage and people are sat there and they're giggling their heads off, I know that I've done my job right.
And from short legs to shortbread. Jen rolls out her pastry.
The pastry's cracking bits, so it could be a bit of a disaster.
Cuts into biscuit-sized pieces.
Not very good at, like, making pastry.
Then sprinkles sugar ready for baking.
I'm intrigued how this is going to work, and homemade shortbread sounds nice.
Completing this week's lineup is 39-year-old Craig Reynolds, who describes himself as a freelance vibes coordinator, whatever that is.
If someone asked what is a vibes coordinator, I would say it's someone that takes the utmost care for their immediate environment in all elements from sound, smell and visual appearance. And that's what I really enjoy doing. I just like making spaces nice for people.
You might want to think about watering that tree. On to the starter, bubble and squeak patty with a poached egg and butter chive sauce.
Bubble and squeak. I used to have that probably supper when I lived up at Yorkshire with my mum and dad.
I think bubble and squeak is quite a lazy dish. That's easy. You just, isn't that the dish where you just chuck everything together, the leftovers from the night before?
Pretty much. Jen mashes together vegetables with potato.
I'm going to make the first one for my pescatarian guests without black pudding.
She then coats in flour and butter. This will chill while she gets on with the meat version for the other three. Next up, the main course. Mountain meatballs stuffed with cheese and served with sweet chili sauce and rice. And for our mystery pescatarian, an aubergine substitute.
I love meatballs. I've never eaten them up a mountain, but I love meatballs. Stuffed with cheese, it depends what cheese it is. If it's like blue cheese, Stilton or all like that, we ain't going to have too well with me.
Jen moulds her patties using breadcrumbs, eggs, spices and ground beef.
Now I'm just going to form my meatballs and stuff them smoked cheese.
These will be baked and then fried later this evening.
Prep's all done there. Really looking forward to meeting my guests. Guess I'd better go and get ready.
Good luck! And first past the post is Lady of the Manor, Michelle.
Hi, I'm Jen. Nice
Hi,
to meet you.
Hi, I'm Michelle. Nice to meet you. How are you?
This is for you.
Thank you very much. That's really kind.
Thank you.
In second place, Yorkshire Terrier, Steve.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Jen. Lovely
to
meet you.
Hi, I'm Steve. Pleased to meet you.
Come in. Yeah, good day.
Yeah, we'll just shake hands with our call from here.
We'll take your word for that. And finally arriving at the junction of Astral Plane 7 and Ley Line 2 is Greg.
Hi, I'm Jen. Lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Pleasure. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers,
everybody.
Coming up, Yorkshire Yak.
Have you never had avocado? No. I'm from Yorkshire, love. I don't eat posh food in Yorkshire.
I think everybody knows that Steve comes from Yorkshire.
And mystic menus.
Tonight for me is about bringing everyone into this magical space that is my home and giving them an experience probably they've never had before.
Is proudly sponsored Hotel True.
It's the first night in Bristol where Jen Watkins hopes to gallop towards a grand. She starts by frying her bubble and squeak alongside the butter sauce.
I was really nervous and excited about meeting everybody, but no, I'm really happy they're here. They all seem like lovely people.
Lastly, she poaches her eggs and voila! Bubble and squeak patty with a poached egg.
And who would like the starter with no meat?
Oh, that's me.
That's the pescatarian mystery soul.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
No problem at all.
That looks amazing.
I could guess that probably Craig was my pescatarian, but I guess that's quite bad of me to stereotype somebody.
Perfect. So, Jen, I'll be honest with you. When I read the menu today, I actually thought it was a single man that didn't know how to cook.
Well, you're partially right.
To me, it was okay, but not the best.
My mum used to make me bubble and squeak for me tea on a Sunday before I went to bed. It's just leftovers.
So who did you guys think was the pescatarian within the group?
I knew it would be Craig. This is a meat and tea veggie.
I think that, like a lot of people, I think I like being a mix of stereotypes and people maybe thinking I'm one way but then realising, no, I'm the other way. And I'm sure that's the same for many people, actually.
I think Craig, he's been quite reserved and just kind of holding back a little bit. I think he has a lot to offer. I think he's a really intelligent guy. I do love the simple things in life. I appreciate everything that I've got. I know I am
being
super lucky.
Because I'm a bit simple.
Really?
No, we will, Steve. Do you know what? I like you already. And, but no, I
think... Michelle is absolutely wonderful. She seems a real, really good bundle of laughs, but she's quite flirtatious. I think she's got a bit of an eye for me, to be honest.
Oh, yeah?
Have you been stereotyped?
I think I have, like, because I'm a Yorkshireman, do you know what I mean? And I've got a bald head and I've got a broad Yorkshire accent and everybody thinks I'm rough and ready and everything else, you know? Mm. I'm probably the type of bloke that people think I go out and have a beer and then I'll have a fisticuffs at the end of the night, and that's completely wrong. I'm an ex-serviceman. I'm now part of the comedy dance act. I'm not a brilliant dancer, but that's what I do.
You get paid to dance badly.
Yeah.
Wow, amazing.
Well, that's one word for it, certainly.
I would like to see Steve dance. Yeah.
I'd be very careful what you wish for.
He is obviously a bit of an act in the fact that he does his comedy dancing. I think he'll need a little bit of reining in throughout the week, but I'm sure we're all strong enough characters to be able to do that.
So everybody's good at something, and I'm good at cooking, so I'm going to win this competition.
Oh, I think so.
I've raised the bar.
She's got no chance. Because... he don't wash with me. It's flirtation. It's me today. Tomorrow night it might be Craig.
This is the most crucial part of my dinner. My meatballs will be fine, my sauce will be fine, my aubergine ball will be fine. It's just the rice that I need to get correct.
It's only rice, Jen. Well, there it is, a mountain meatball, stuffed with cheese and served with sweet chilli sauce and rice. Oh, and a leaf.
What's the
cheese, Jen?
Smoked cheese.
A smoked cheese. Ooh.
The rice is actually cooked perfectly. And that's one thing that I do actually really struggle to cook. Rice was good. The smoked cheese, not enough cheese in the middle.
The meatballs were really lovely. There's not better than a meaty ball.
I think the sauce really just turned me off of the whole dish, actually.
Time for dessert. Irish coffee with homemade shortbread.
So, Jen, what's at the bottom?
Well...
Oof!
Got a kick to it.
The bottom is a coffee liqueur.
Ah, that's why it's making me cough a little bit.
Okay.
And the top has got an Irish cream liqueur in it. It is quite strong, isn't it?
Yeah.
Texted!
It was too creamy on top, and the chocolate was too gooey and too strong.
I wouldn't say maybe it's a winning food night, but hopefully everybody's felt comfortable and had a nice time.
The dessert was absolutely delicious, but the starter and the main just wasn't to my taste, so I'm going to give Jen a 6.
The food wasn't to my standard. It lacked flavour and spice, so therefore I'm giving Jen a 5.
To be honest, I'd have just liked to see more of her personality over the course of the evening, so I'm giving her a 6.
Which gives Jen a very, very average 17. It's day 2 of the competition, and Craig is living up to his job description as freelance vibes coordinator.
Tonight for me is about bringing everyone into this magical space that is my home and giving them an experience probably they've never had before.
I think it's going to be quite healthy, organic. I just hope there's not too many nuts and seeds, because I don't like nuts and seeds.
I think my little temple flat speaks a lot about what I'm kind of into and the vibe that I kind of like to share. So yeah, they're definitely going to get to see and hear and smell a lot of the things I'm into.
And I hope tonight that Steve shuts up and lets other people talk for a change.
I think my behaviour is going to stay exactly the same, probably a little bit more naughty, to be honest.
And talking of naughty things, time to prep Craig's dessert. Berry choc heaven.
I love chocolate and I love berries.
Maybe not as good as my chocolate, but we'll see.
So this is cacao butter. It's so simple to make your own super high grade chocolate. You just need cacao paste, cacao powder, and a nice sweetener. Raw chocolate doesn't taste the same as a chocolate bar you get from the newsagent, but that for me, that's why it's so good. And maybe the first bite they'll be like, And maybe the second bite they'll be like, And I think by the third bite they'll be like, wow.
Let's just hope the fourth bite isn't followed by, oh goodness, what?
The only thing is your sweetener. This is our agave nectar. It's organic, natural, comes from a cactus. A bazillion times better than sugar. It's funny because normally I just do this.
Well, don't mind us.
All right.
Finally, the chocolate is chilled, just like everything else. Onto the main course, the elusively titled Buddha plate.
I'm not quite sure on that one. Maybe some like onion bhaji type things. I don't know what Buddhas eat, to be honest.
I'm hoping that it's like a curry or something that he's picked up on his travels to India. That would be really nice, with a nice rice.
So now we're going to make cauliflower rice.
Glad to hear it. Plain old rice is boring.
You just grate it and you fry it. All right, there we go. Cauliflower rice. Nice.
Next, he turns up the heat on onions and chilies.
Going to get hot, hot, hot. Put in the ginger.
Then he adds spices and spinach.
I believe every single person holds the power of the universe. We're all really magical, special creatures, and we all just basically want the best for everyone.
Took the words right out of my mouth.
Looking good, smelling good. All right, now we're gonna put in almond cream. I think now I'm gonna add the final magic ingredient, the almond cheese. That's epic.
And from epic to epicurean with the starter of the blue fun guy.
The blue fun guy.
Say it quickly. Blue fun guy.
A blue fish, maybe?
Well, no.
Is there a blue fish?
No, there isn't.
Fun guy is mushroom.
Well, thank you, Steve.
And this, to me, sounds like mushrooms stuffed with blue cheese. And I don't like any of them.
Steve's nightmare begins with Craig preparing his not-so-magic mushrooms to be cooked later, leaving just enough time to boil his beetroots.
Done all the homemade prep of the food. Now time to put on some homemade clothes.
I think he's a very chilled, laid-back person, and I can just imagine him now, barefoot, in his kitchen.
Well, almost.
I'm ready.
Excellent. First, across the threshold of a dream, is Michelle.
Hello. Hi, Michelle, welcome. Nice to see you. Hi. Elderflower and sparkling rose.
Next, bearing gifts from not so far, is Steve.
Hey, Steve.
Hello,
how are
you, pal?
Good, nice to see you.
Nice day, I love it, man.
Thank you.
Brilliant.
Welcome. See what you think.
It's good, it's nice, refreshing.
And last up is Jen.
Hey, Jen. Hey, nice to see you. Welcome.
What?
Doesn't like it.
I don't like it. Do you like it? Jungle.
You're trouble, you are. You're sneaky.
And Craig, what is this we're drinking?
It's elderflower and rose.
It's delicious. Thank you very much.
Is it different?
It's delicious. Yeah, it is, right?
Steve drank all of it.
Oh, you liked it? Good.
Yeah, I'm thirsty.
Okay. Definitely getting nice vibes from the guests. They seem more comfortable than I expected, actually, which is a nice surprise.
Cheers.
Welcome to the temple.
Thank you.
It's just an honour to welcome everyone into this space because it's geared just to welcome people, basically, and make them feel relaxed and comfortable. And I'm always inspired when I see people happy when they arrive. That's nice.
Your starter for Zen. Organic portobello mushrooms fried in coconut with melted palm fresh blue cheese and walnuts on a bed of spinach leaf. I thought it was supposed to be blue.
May I present, ladies and gentlemen, the blue fungi.
Thank you very much. It looks delicious.
Steve, any other friends?
I'm not sure Steve has achieved a state of nirvana quite yet.
I will try anything once, but I've tried mushrooms lots of times and get the same result, and the result's worse every time, you know, and I just can't stand, like, even the thought of putting it in my mouth.
Was that going to take the plate away?
If you don't mind.
No problem.
Does it smell of it? As soon as he brought it in, I just thought, you've got no chance, mate.
I was a little bit surprised when Steve point blank refused to eat his starter. I thought there was elements on the dish that maybe he could have tried.
Well, perhaps the main course will be more suited to Steve's delicate palate.
So the almond palak paneer is culminating into its desired magnificence. Smelling good. Tasting good.
Oh, come on, Craig, that's been in your mouth. Yeah, well, it's on the plate now. Organic cauliflower coconut fried rice with red onions, avocado, roasted sweet potato and fried tempeh. Topped with pan-fried sunflower seeds and almonds and a satay sauce.
Or by its other name, vegan mess.
Flute solo.
It is my pleasure to serve you the magical Buddha plates.
There you go, ladies. They look amazing.
And what about the food that's on them?
Thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Lovely.
Anyone experiencing enlightenment yet?
Maybe it's because I was starving, because I didn't have a starter. But it was just an explosion of flavour. But the more I ate it, the worse it got.
My favourite thing on the plate? It's the spinach and cheese. Mm-hmm. I love the spice.
Mm-hmm.
It's not too much, it's just like a nice kick.
Mm-hmm.
It's perfect. A little bit nutty, a little bit seedy for me.
That's no way to talk about Steve!
It was everything I was hoping it would be. A crazy side of Craig, that all the different things he likes to eat. Absolutely delicious.
Well, Steve, can absolutely. You have avocado, please?
Of course you can, yeah. I'm just not an avocado person because I've never tried before and I need to try it.
Have you never had avocado?
No. I'm from Yorkshire, love. I don't eat posh foods in Yorkshire.
I think everybody knows that Steve comes from Yorkshire because every other word is, I'm a Yorkshire, I'm a Yorkshire lad, I'm a Yorkshire tea, Yorkshire. We all know that Steve comes from Yorkshire.
You know what we have up in Yorkshire? Chips and mushy peas. Avocado. It's just even how you say it, isn't it?
The fact that Steve thinks I'm posh, I do find a little bit offensive.
Steve thinks Jen's posh, which I find hilarious, although she has a posh accent.
I'm a Yorkshireman, everybody else sat around the table, they're talking oolagada, avocado and all this sort of stuff. And that's not me, you know, so I do think that I'm definitely the misfit.
You could maybe say I was posh when I used to work as an accountant, maybe. You would think that would
really?
Be a very posh thing to do.
I did
a train to be a chartered accountant for 2 years, and at the end of it, I was just like, no.
I was quite shocked when I found out Craig was once an accountant. I didn't really see him as that type of person.
I actually thought that maybe he worked on a farm in Goa, you know, helping to herd sheep or something like that.
What, like a chartered shepherd?
And ever since then, I just went on a path of being an artist and doing projects that I felt were really nourished my soul. So, ladies and gentlemen, come join me for an improvised freestyle musical show.
Get in! I've only got my kazoo with me. Here we go.
A really fun way for all of us to kind of bond together, play different instruments that we've never seen or played before.
Sometimes I'm a little bit shy with things like that, but I didn't have any doubts that I could get involved with this tonight. He made me feel really at ease.
And now you can all attain greater wisdom with the dessert. Freshly made raw chocolate with homemade organic blueberry and banana sorbet and honey vanilla sauce.
Thank you. Oh, wow.
Thank you.
My pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Berry Chuck.
Anything to do with berries, spot on.
Yeah,
I like certain berries. I don't like all berries. You know, strawberries, blueberries, raspberries.
I like all berries. Nickberry, Chuckberry, lots of them.
Oh, come on. Surely Mary Berry's the go-to berry.
Everything I've served you tonight's all been organic. The banana's organic, the blueberries are organic, all the chocolate and grapes are organic.
Wait for it.
I don't know about this being organic. It tastes organic to me.
Hooray! Taxes!
The dessert were absolutely fine. Berries, banana, chocolate, just what I like.
Well, I like the food I cook. I'd have given myself a 9.
I enjoyed the entertainment, but I really didn't like the starter or dessert, so I'm going to give Craig a 5.
Tonight, Craig cooked his really interesting food, and his entertainment was fantastic, and for that reason, I'm going to give him an 8.
Unfortunately for me, the main course just lacked one little ingredient, so that was meat. Therefore, I'm giving Craig a 6.
But despite that, some terrific vibe coordination means that Craig takes the lead with 19. Coming up, excruciating exercises. Go!
It's just a million planet solar systems away from the style that I enjoy.
And confident cooking.
Perfect.
Day 3 in Bristol, and 39-year-old joker Steve Legg is about to start preparing his food. Or perhaps not. I wonder what this sexy beast has up his sleeve. Sexy Beast is a film, by the way.
This week's been a little bit boring, if I'm totally honest with myself. I just felt a little bit let down and a little bit gutted. But tonight, they're coming to my house.
I think tonight Steve will be a bit quieter.
Nuh-uh.
It's party time!
Normal service has been resumed. That's quite enough of that, Steve. Get on with your dessert, fella. Wild berry tiramisu.
Tiramisu? No. Wild berry tiramisu? I'm making tiramisu. Battle of the tiramisus, then.
Looks like it. Steve soaks waffles in a mixture of espresso coffee and amaretto liqueur.
This is going to be absolutely immense, the flavour. I once went into a club and a bloke said, "You got a tear." I said, "Where?" He said, "In your suit." I said, "What, a tear in my suit?"
Hi, hi, y'all.
I don't think that Steve is adverse to moderately serious conversation. I just think he likes to think he's the Joker.
The Joker now blends together eggs and sugar before adding mascarpone cheese.
Fantastic. 2 or 3 tablespoons of amaretto to give it that little bit of a kick that it needs.
Absolutely. The mixture is placed in glasses and popped into chill till later. On to the starter. Loaded peppers.
Be interesting to see what they're actually loaded with.
Well, let's find out, shall we? Steve builds his load with rice, courgettes and tomato sauce before adding salmon for Craig and chorizo for the meat version.
That is a starter done.
Finally, it's the main. Medallions of beef topped with mushroom and cheese with chunky sweet potato fries. And what about Craig?
For Craig, I've got a steak alternative. And I just really hope he appreciates the effort that I've gone to making this for him.
How could he not?
Yeah, it's a bit of a 1990s vegetarian kind of option. But yeah, hats off for Steve for trying to make me something that, to include me in the meal. I really appreciate that.
I can't believe he's cooking mushrooms. The fuss that he made last night at Craig's house.
I'm quite shocked about the fact there's mushrooms on there. But maybe he's doing that to make us happy and he won't put the mushrooms in his.
Only looks to be three.
That's all my prep done. And now I'm going to get ready for my party!
I think if he just didn't try, I think he'd pull off an amazing night. But I think if he tries too much, it might accidentally actually hinder the whole vibe.
That is certainly possible.
I've got the fruits of love and the flowers of passion. Sounds like my first guest.
It's Michelle.
Hello.
Hi, Steve.
Come on through, come on through.
Closely followed by genuinely jolly Jen.
Hello, Steve.
And then foinkly fulsome Craig.
Craig, my main man.
Welcome to my party! Cheers, everybody.
And the first party trick is to get the starters stuffed and cooked. Well, that was quick. A loaded pepper.
Here we go. Could you pass that to Jen, please, Craig?
Okay. Good job those plates aren't hot.
And this is yours, my friend.
Thank you so much.
No problem. I don't know if you've noticed, but if you turn your plate around, you'll see that this is a happy house. We don't have any negativity, so I've put a smiley face on there that might cheer you up.
Oh, oh, making it so pumpkin where you can't.
Yeah, that's just because I like smiles and everything, you know. At the end of the day, it's got to be good vibes, and that's all I can say. How's the salmon? Is it any good?
It's good, yeah, different. Yeah. I've never had this kind of combination before, so that's cool.
Okay.
Something interesting.
Being a pescatarian is not a disability or anything like that. It's a life choice, and it's quite difficult for someone like me to decide what am I going to cook for this person.
The loaded peppers were okay, but they didn't blow my mind.
And we ladies have got exactly the same, but instead of smoked salmon, we've got chorizo sausage meat.
Okay. I'm not a fan, Steve. Is that okay if I just kind of push those
It's your food on your plate, you eat whatever you like. I'm not offended at all because at the end of the day, not everybody likes the same thing, which is absolutely fine.
Yeah.
I just like a little bit of spicy meat inside it, you know.
Yeah.
It just, for me, it does it.
There was nothing that I liked about the starter. It was cold, it was tasteless.
Michelle, I think she enjoyed it more than what she's letting on, apart from the chisori sausage meat.
Yeah, nobody likes chisori.
Coming from Yorkshire, we always used to go hunting rabbits.
No, Stevie, from Yorkshire.
Yeah, I've not mentioned that.
I thought you were a Bristol lad.
We used to go hunting rabbits when we were younger, and, you know, it's just one of them things that you do when, you know, you hunt the rabbits, you catch them, you sell them to the butchers. Fortunately for me, I don't do anything like that anymore. It's just a thing that I went through, a phase that I went through when I were younger.
Do you not like hunting now, then?
I'm not really for fox hunting and stuff like that, you know, and people are not doing that to survive. Like when I were a kid, we used to do it to earn a little bit extra money for our mum and dad.
Have you ever seen what a fox would do to a parrot, like a load of lambs?
At the dinner table, especially with new guests and new friends, I think to instigate a conversation about anything that's heavy, like fox hunting or politics, is not something that I'd do.
The vibes would be all over the place.
The reason I go is because I'm from a farming background, and I have seen them wipe out large percentages of a salary for the year. The conversation about fox hunting gave me the opportunity to come out of my shell and actually let me have my opinions heard.
It was amazing to actually see that other side of Jen, because she's been quite quiet and shy.
Life, no matter if you're a fox, whether you're a squirrel, or whether you're a human being, life is really precious no matter what.
I think it really got on Steve's nerves. I don't think he liked it. I think he actually felt quite challenged.
It was nice that no fight broke out, and it was nice to hear two different views being shared and that being accepted, but it definitely added a bit of a heaviness.
I can't stop talking because this is my party and we're going to have fun.
Absolutely fine.
Time for the main course.
I'm just trying to cook this medium to well because it's a mixture of everything. If people like it well done, then I think I'm not going to be too far off. If they like it medium, I don't think that the two girls like it rare.
Oh, nice choice of cheese. I hope it's Wensleydale. In all its glory, medallion of beef. Topped with farmhouse mushroom and cheese with a special peppercorn sauce. Reaches the action.
There we go, my dear.
Thank you.
Now, I hope you enjoy it as much as I have cooking it.
Oh, if only.
Oh,
yes,
thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bon appetit. So ladies and gentlemen, I present to you meat and two veg.
Thank you.
Or in your case, Craig, veg.
Thank you.
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 Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Th
veg and one veg.
Comedy gold!
Fantastic.
Steve, where's your mushroom?
I don't like mushrooms.
No.
Really? Why did you cook us mushrooms?
Yeah, like mushrooms. I'm a big believer that just because I don't like something doesn't mean that I shouldn't let anybody else eat it.
Okay.
You know? And it complements, apparently it complements the beef. The reason why I didn't ask how you like your beef is because there's that many different people liking it that many different ways, and to be honest with you, I can't be bothered with that.
Now that's what I call hospitality!
He didn't ask us how we wanted our steak cooked, and I think that's a massive no-no.
I mean, I'm not sure if it was a payback, the meal in itself, but it was really not tasty, and it was out of a packet, and I thought the point was just to make something fresh for your guests, and that element was missing for me.
I just want to ask one more thing. Do you think that hunting is a class thing?
I don't think that you're stuck up or anything.
Okay.
I really don't. You've got a posh accent, but then again, everybody's got a posh accent for me because I'm a broad Yorkshireman.
Never!
You know what I mean? So there's no nastiness here whatsoever, so please don't feel offended.
It's never really been said that I've got a posh accent. It's
I quite like it.
A farmer accent, like West Country type accent.
I don't think that anybody around this table is stuck up their own backside. Okay, I don't think that anybody is punching above their weight, and I don't think anybody's hoity-toity or anything like that. Please don't be offended, because I didn't mean for it to feel like that, honestly.
Yeah,
get out of my pub! Let's have a drink. Come on, it's meant to be a party, innit? I've got a little surprise up my sleeve for them, because they've all said at the other dinner parties that they love a little bit of a dance, a little bit of a boogie.
I'm afraid it's now showtime!
One, two, three, let's go! Wave your hands!
I'm not sure that I would pay to go and see that. Let's try pizza.
Go!
It's just a million planet solar systems away from the style that I enjoy.
And if you'd like to see more of this, you're pretty much on your own.
Somebody call me a taxi.
Sadly, taxis are delayed until after dessert.
Whether they enjoyed my food or not is irrelevant, because I did show them how to have a little bit of a party in there.
Looks like Michelle's having her own party. Homemade tiramisu, served with chocolate-coated nuts and wild berries, straight from the freezer.
And this is the Pierre de Resistance.
Who is Pierre de Resistance?
Don't just get a bit of cream and berry, you need to dig right down to the bottom and taste that nice coffee liqueur at the bottom, because it's not very strong. This is actually one of my favourite puddings, and I come across the berries by mistake, because normally I serve chocolate coated nuts with tiramisu, and I didn't have any nuts, and my fiancé said we've got some berries in the fridge, and so I'll try it, but it doesn't sound like it's going to go, and I put it on and thought, oh wow, it really does compliment it.
Can I just ask one thing? Are they just not frozen berries that have been defrosted?
No, they've not been frozen berries.
Taxis!
It was a package for you, it definitely wasn't fresh. Dessert for me was a dessert disaster.
Quite honestly, with all the effort I've put in, I deserve at least an 8 or a 9.
I didn't like the food, I didn't enjoy the entertainment, so I'm going to give Steve a 3.
Tonight, I'm going to give Steve a 6. He tried really hard for us all, but his food and entertainment weren't that great.
Positive vibes are there, but the stress, pressure got the better of him tonight, and the food just wasn't up to par.
So Steve's decidedly poor score means he won't be laughing all the way to the bank. It's the final day in Bath, and hostess Michelle Sanfilippo is hoping to get her grubby hands on 1,000 Bristol pounds with an evening of quality.
If I had to sum up the dinner parties this week, I would say it really felt like you were just going to a friend's house for a quick get-together and a simple plate of food.
I'm looking forward to seeing how Michelle lives, what her house is like, what her cooking's like. She has been playing a little bit of Lady of the Manor, so we'll see if she lives up to that reputation.
Now we will see a proper dinner party. My table setting's going to be beautiful, I'm going to have fresh flowers, real napkins. It's going to actually feel like a proper dinner party, or like going out to a lovely restaurant and sitting down and being served good food.
I think Michelle's house will have a nice vibe. It will be different, obviously, to the style that I'm accustomed to, but I like meeting different people and seeing different people's homes.
First up, dessert. Tiramisu made with Italian coffee and amaretto.
Game on then, is it? Dessert. Tiramisu made with Italian coffee and amaretto. That's why Michelle was laughing all the way through my pudding and didn't even eat it, because she's made more or less the same as me, except I had beautiful wild berries in mine.
Yes, Michelle begins her prep by mixing mascarpone cheese with cream in one of her many labour-saving devices. She then adds a generous shot of amaretto.
Steve put waffles at the bottom of his tiramisu yesterday, which was really strange. So I'm actually using the traditional ladyfinger biscuits. This is traditional Italian coffee that I'm using. I could be wrong. I think Steve might find fault in my tiramisu.
I'm hoping Michelle's going to put on a cracking party, and I just want to have some fun. That's basically all what it's all about for me.
I hope he likes it.
On to the starter, gamberoni picante with homemade bread.
Gamberoni, I have no idea what that is.
You're kidding.
I do not have a clue whatsoever what that is.
Not you as well.
Never heard of it.
That's less surprising. Meanwhile, Michelle makes her bread, no doubt the traditional way.
I'm actually using a bread maker. It's not cheap tin.
It is.
It's still homemade. Start, and that's on. Okay. So this is my homemade tomato sauce that I'm going to be using for my prawns. So in here I have fresh tomatoes, chilies that I grew, garlic, I've added a few chili flakes, and parsley and basil.
Finally the main course, salmon fillet in a sweet chili sauce.
Just for Craig. It's good to see the main tonight is the first time I've had the chance to sample some fish. I do like fish. So, I'm pleased to see some pescatarian, palatable perfection on my plate tonight.
My homemade secret seasoning.
Oh, what's that then?
But it's a secret, I'm not telling you. It's my secret recipe.
Be like that. The salmon will now rest quietly in the designer fridge. Now for the meat eater's main.
Chicken in breadcrumbs with garlic, asparagus, stuffed zucchinis and rosemary potatoes. That sounds absolutely delicious. I'm really looking forward to trying that.
Michelle coats the chicken breast in seasoned flour and butter.
I go way over the top with the breadcrumbs.
The chicken goes into chill until later.
I don't know what zucchini, stuffed zucchini or zucchini, whatever it's called. I ain't got a clue what that is.
We'll let Michelle show you.
If these go right, I've got a good chance of winning, so fingers crossed for the zucchini.
Otherwise known as courgettes. The seasoned courgettes are shallow fried and then rolled.
Oh, it's a perfect one. Okay, all my food prep's done. Now it's time to prep myself and go and get glammed up for my dinner guests.
Under starter's orders, it's Jen.
Hello.
Hey, Willoughby, how are you?
Hi.
Lovely, thank you very much.
Cheers. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
At one with the universe, it's Craig.
Hello, my lovely.
Hi,
good
nice
evening,
to
come
see
on
you.
In. How are you?
Hey, Craig.
Hey, nice to
how
see
are you.
You. Good, thank you. How are
nice
you?
Good to see you.
All good?
Yeah, very good, thank you.
Wow, what a day, what a place. Looks beautiful.
And hoping to soak up more than just sun, it's Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Hello, Michelle.
How are you? I'm good, how are you?
God, nice to see you.
I have some champagne, or I have your special brew that you like. What would you prefer?
It's proper champagne. I like
it's
a glass of champagne. Yeah. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Last night, let's have some fun.
We will.
Cheers, have a lovely evening.
Coming up, four performances.
Let's have a bit of beatboxing. Come on, babe.
Oh, baby.
And the winner is revealed.
Yeah. In second place.
This program is proudly sponsored by Trivago. Hotel Trivago.
Plants are the new cows. They're in the field all year round and only need a bit of sun and water to grow the seeds we use to make new Flora buttery. It's our richest buttery spread and now tastes better than ever. New Flora buttery, delicious taste, made with plants.
Creamy ricotta and spinach girasoli. It's going down a treat. Aldi, voted Britain's best value supermarket.
For people, for plans, for 200 years. Riviera Travel brings you the world. We've handpicked the best it has to offer.
so you can feel India, as well as see and hear it. Or...
Final night in Bath, and personal stylist Michelle Sanfilippo is hoping to net a grand with an evening of fine dining. First up, Michelle sautés her prawns whilst adding cream to the sauce. She finally combines the two and arrives at a conclusion.
Perfect.
Of course.
Oh, that's really good. Just how I wanted it to be.
Italian-style gamberone picante.
American-style portion.
This is your gamberone picante, and this is your bruschetta on homemade bread.
Oh, it's delicious, thank you very much.
Welcome to my home, please enjoy my food.
The prawns were delicious, but there was sort of almost a main course at the start. I couldn't eat it all.
I'm a little bit bored, to be honest.
Why?
Because I don't like prawns, but I will try the sauce and everything.
Yeah, definitely.
It's just the prawns are not my...
Yeah, no, that's absolutely fine.
They just disagree with me. The sauce was good, but I was just a little bit let down that I couldn't eat the fish or the prawns because it's just not to my taste.
After Mushroom Gate, I'm not really sure with which foods he does and doesn't like.
I've got my eye on Steve, and I am worried that he will try to sabotage my night.
I cook a lot of Italian food, and I am basically self-taught.
Shut up! Women can't cook this good, surely not.
Who do you think cooked that for you, Steve?
Probably Gordon Ramsay, Jamie Oliver. I'm only joking.
I know you are.
I'm really not down with making jokes degrading women in any way. It's just something that's not... I don't think it's funny. I think it's a kind of a joke mode from prehistoric times.
I've been told of loads of people I'm overpowering and I talk a lot and I butt in conversations, but I can't help it because it's just how I am and I've got to say it here and then, otherwise I'm stuffed.
I just want to say one thing, that I also am a bit of a chatterbox, but sometimes you learn so much just from listening. And often, many times over the last few days, I'm like, I really want to say something, I really want to say something, but everyone's in the flow, so I've just sat back.
I think Craig's advice to Steve tonight about listening a little bit to other people and their opinions would actually help him a long way in his life and the path he wants to take for his future.
Michelle's path includes taking Craig's fish to the oven, the courgettes to the grill, and the chicken to the frying pan, and there we have it. Chicken and breadcrumbs with garlic asparagus stuffed zucchinis and rosemary potatoes, while Craig dines on salmon fillet in a sweet chili sauce.
What is this? Because I've never heard of zucchini or zucchini.
Okay.
When you've got the menu, I'm like, I ain't got a clue what that is.
It's a courgette.
Oh, God, yeah!
I was trying to posh up the menu, Steve.
Rather a pointless gesture.
If you'd have called it a stuffed courgette, I'd have known exactly what I'm getting.
Okay.
Now, until I've asked you what that is, I will try that until you tell me it's a courgette.
Okay.
Try it. I mean, that's just me. I'm a Yorkshireman.
Yeah.
Here we go again.
Plain and simple, tell me what it is. Do you know what I mean? Say what you see. That's what I like.
Oh, I love a good catchphrase too.
The main course was really delicious. Quite a lot of potato for a main course after such a big starter. But no, I did enjoy it.
The main course, I really appreciate you cooked me some nice fish. And it was well cooked.
And now it's hidden talent time.
Often when I'm in the kitchen, what I like to do is beatbox.
I saw a bit of beatboxing. Come on, babe.
I've mislaid my kazoo. Michelle thinks she can sprinkle a little magic on her dessert. They don't each get one of them, do they? Crikey, tiramisu!
I can appreciate that they are big portions. Please don't feel as if you have to eat the whole thing, but just tuck in and enjoy what you can, okay?
When I see your menu today,
uh-huh,
I was absolutely gutted that you were doing tiramisu.
He was.
For one,
okay,
it's my favourite pudding in the whole world.
It is.
And for two, nobody can make it as good as me.
Well, you've lost me there, Steve.
It's absolutely delicious.
Oh, thank you. Do you like it?
I do like it, but not as much as what I like my own.
I think tiramisu really needs to be well soaked, especially the sponge part. That's why I use waffles, because it soaks up a lot quicker.
And yet the ladyfingers seem very, very popular. And they're crunchy too, by the sound of things.
It was more like an entire galaxy of tiramisu rather than just a nice portion.
It was delicious, absolutely delicious. No comparison to Steve's tiramisu from last night.
Time to find out who's won the prize.
Tonight, I'm going to give Michelle a 7.
Her food was really, really nice, but not 100% up to scratch. There wasn't any entertainment, so I'm going to give her a very modest 7.
Tonight, I'm giving Michelle...
Hold it right there! Michelle now needs 6 points or more to win. As the final host, it's down to Michelle to reveal those results.
In fourth place, Steve. In third place is Jen. In second place is Craig.
Jen scored Michelle 7, giving her a total of 21.
Oh my god, this is amazing. I never win anything.
I'm really pleased that Michelle came in first, but what I'm actually more pleased about is that I came third and not last.
Well done, mate.
What I walk away with is knowing that whatever I'm doing in life is exactly what I'm meant to be doing.
What, losing?
Well done, Michelle.
It's almost... I don't know, I can't put it into words, I can't describe it. I just feel... Yeah, I'm really pleased with myself, I'm really proud of myself. Yeah.
Don't stop talking, you know what's going to happen!
Now, my food was so yummy, you should have gave me the money.
Now that is funny.
Caramel wheat was a bit sticky for someone, but don't worry, they're back tonight with...